Hey guys, Josh at Bane Tech, and I've got the B-Typer Bluetooth Keyboard by GGMM. This is probably my favorite Bluetooth keyboard that I've used to date. Along with the keyboard, you get a pretty cool looking cable, and this is going to be one that you kind of want to keep around just because it looks cool and you know it's going to be good quality. The build quality feels awesome. This thing just feels really nice and natural. This feels like a laptop keyboard. I really like typing on a laptop keyboard. It's my personal preference. I really like it. The other thing, the finish is a brushed aluminum. You got that on the front and on the back. It's got this nice white border. You got some nice rubber stoppers here. It's really thin. Like, I just really like how this is treating me so far. I've been using it for a few days now. I've used it for multiple different devices. Actually, my favorite device that I've used it with is my PlayStation 4. Reason is because the PlayStation app on my phone or any other device is just really slow. And being that the app really is struggling on the PlayStation side, it's just a lot easier to be able to type out a message usually on a phone. And it really sucks to try to type out a message on a PlayStation controller. So the alternative is to try to, you know, type it out on this game controller, and it's like trying to just single tap a message, and it just gets really annoying. So I busted this out, and I was in the middle of trying to get my app working, and it just wasn't working great. So I took this out and connected it to the PlayStation and then just started typing away. And it was so much easier to type it on this versus the PlayStation controller, or alternatively waiting an hour for the PlayStation app to actually start working. I've been using it more with my PlayStation 4, but I know that a lot of people are probably going to be more interested in using it for a phone or a tablet. So let's go ahead and get both of those connected and see how it works with it. The power switch is on the right-hand side. It's got a little toggle. This is also where you charge it with your USB connector. To get everything up and running, let's go ahead and get to our settings, get to our Bluetooth settings, turn it on, make sure everything's all up. All right, so there's a little trick once you get this turned on. It's really simple. You just hit function and C together to get the Bluetooth to be able to connect it into pairing mode. So once you turn it on, go ahead and press it. You only got a few seconds to press it, and you should start seeing the Bluetooth light start to blink. And now on your device, you should see stuff, something pop up. If not, most devices have a refresh, so just hit refresh. There it is, the Bluetooth 3.0 keyboard. We're going to do that, and it gives me a pairing code. Now for this device, you're actually going to have to put in a code, so you just simply type in whatever code pops up onto your screen. It went away. Let's try that again. So if it goes away, just hit it again. All right, so here's my number. Gonna type it in. Hit enter. And we're all connected. To get going, one of the neat things that you can do is that you can control a lot of stuff on this phone. And you can just simply hit the space bar to wake it up. And you got you there, you know, home screen or lock screen. Let's see what else this can do. We got some brightness, some volume, some play kind of features. Yep, so you can control your brightness. That's pretty cool. I'm just going to start pressing buttons. There's my browser. We got search. Let's see how that works. So the Google search works. It brings up everything that you were looking for. You got your basically Google Now app that activates. That's pretty cool. So we got a forward button. We got our play and pause. So let's see if I activate that, if my Google Play music will pop up. Nope. So we do have volume control. That's pretty cool. And then if you want to make your phone go to sleep, you got your sleep-wake option here. So that's really cool. You got a lot of different shortcuts that you can get up here. I like it. Before we go any further, let's just kind of give an overview of all the keys. I went over all the top ones here that I can do on my Android device. That's the Nexus 6, by the way. And you got your function key here on the corner. So when you want to activate that stuff, you just hold that down and press the function key. Otherwise, you're just going to get your normal different kind of codes right here, your numbers and your symbols. And this actually helps a lot because you got an iOS, Android, and Windows options here. So you have an iOS device, an Android device, or you're using it on a computer, or even a Windows phone. You're going to have those kind of options can help cater to that device, which is really cool. A nice little attention to detail thing that they put into this keyboard. So you got pretty much all the different keys that you're going to need. You got your page up and down, you get your arrows, you got some different commands down here, Windows commands, Alt, Control, Shift, Cap Lock. Everything that you're going to need. So let's give some little typing. Now forgive me if I don't type that great, because trying to wrap your hands around the camera and doing this and typing at the same time. It's actually kind of difficult, so it's not going to be completely natural, but just bear with me as I try to get this all typed out. Now let's see if I want to, yeah, I can go up and down, so that's pretty cool. You can see the cursor going between the title and then the note. So let's just do a test. And that's pretty cool. And if you got autocorrect, that's going to save your life. Now something I wanted to try out, let's see, you know, to start off with, we are typing on the GGM. You're going to have to hit your cap locks and then type something to, in order to get the cap locks all the way. Or you can, you know, you can double tap and that'll bring it, whatever your keyboard settings are, I think that's going to be the factor involved as well. Yeah, so you can hold down the cap locks and that does the same thing. So that works pretty cool on my Nexus 6. Let's go ahead and get this connected to an iPad. All right, so on the iPad, let's go to our settings. I've got my Bluetooth turned on and we're going to go ahead and get this set up. If you want to get into pairing mode on the keyboard, you're going to want to hit function and C. And you should see it pop up right here, which it does. All right, so we got a pairing request, so we're going to type in the code that it's given on the screen. There we go. And it's connected, so let's go ahead and get some typing going. All right, so I got the iPad pulled up, got my WordPress app going just to show you an example of how you could use this in your everyday life. If you're on a plane, you're traveling, you're in the car, you're a passenger, just something like that, it's a lot easier to carry an iPad versus a whole blown out keyboard. Not to mention, with most iPads and tablets, you're not gonna have to worry about plugging up the iPad to a power source because the battery life is gonna be better than a laptop. Not to mention, in college, schools, even high schools these days, you can use an iPad to take your notes, your class notes, and it's a lot easier to bring an iPad than it is a whole laptop. So let's go ahead and just do a little bit of typing and then we'll get into some other functions. All right, so. Again, just really apologize for my bad typing. It's been really rough this last week. And I think you can just hit tab, yep, hit tab to go down to the bottom, the next line, or, you know, the paragraph section versus the title area. So there's some typing that we can do. Let's go ahead and open up some of the other functions that you can do with this keyboard as well. Let's see if I can open up my music app on this. It doesn't open it up, so let's go to the music app and see what it does. All right, so it's playing. I'm not gonna play it too loud. But there, you can do your play and pause. You can see the little icon switching over here. You can skip the tracks. So that's pretty cool. Let's see if we can go back. Not with that app because it's a radio. So that's pretty cool. If you want to go back to the home screen, you just hit function and the escape and that brings you back to the home screen. The search works. Got our brightness controls. Your sleep-wake option. Got our volume. Like I said at the beginning of the video, this has been a keyboard that I've really enjoyed using. I really like the design. It's really thin. It works really nice with just typing. It feels pretty comfortable. I just like the build quality a lot. It's the best build quality I've had as far as a Bluetooth keyboard goes. I really enjoy using it with my PlayStation 4. It's going to be useful for iPads as well. I'm going to be able to use this for a lot of different uses. I'm pretty positive that you'll like this. And if you get it, let me know. And I'll leave a link down below if you do want to get it. And guys, if you thought that this video was helpful to you, please give a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed yet, please do so you can see more videos like this. Yeah.